Great, guys, we are Praveen and Dhruv, and we were here around 2 weeks back. And what we do is we call ourselves A4, and we started off as researching within the domain of crafts, and then we came across a method of research called speculative design and discursive design. In gathering research through these practices. And so moving on from crafts, we just wrapped up our craft bit a few days back. And the new workshop, we try to scope the trends that are there right now. And work from home seemed to be a very, it's everybody knows that this is the new paradigm right now. And so we wanted to explore that, what people think of work from home and what people really aspire from this whole phenomenon, that how do they want to work from home more than how it is right now, and more than the natural growth it's going to take. We really want to tap into like aspirations of the people, like what people want from their culture of work from home or working from anywhere for that matter. And so we had like a few prompts at the starting. These were the questions that we were just asking, that what are the usual conversations that happen in a work from home environment, and can you hear me? And then we started to kind of, you know, build our own stories, that what else can happen? Can the digital avatar just fly away from the screen? And does work from anywhere implies that the person's geography or geographical location is really an ambiguous space right now, that a person can be sitting inside a shikara or can be traveling in a plane and still be working. So such interesting cues we try to understand with our conversations. And so moving on, what exactly is A4 and Achar? So the word A4, if you literally translate it into Hindi, it becomes achar. And the point of achar was to pickle ideas, and speculation and pickling have some sort of things in common, that you mix a lot of things together, you mix a lot of triggers together, you try to arrange them in a particular order, and the taste or the result comes out after a certain point of time. So that became kind of a name. And I think Praveen would like to say something here about the thing.
Thanks, Dhruv. Hello, everyone. So I would just like to address some things which we got through conversations after the last session. So it was, we were very happy to see like a lot of people appreciated the speculative achar session. And we figured that, okay, there is a space in India, especially where we could talk about India-centric speculation and what our aspirations towards futures are, instead of taking cues or even processes from the Western concepts. So I just wanted to address few things before we move on. Was that we guys are open to collaborate or to work on different things. It's just that. And we have really appreciated those responses we got from few people about some very hard social issues also. It's just that, you know, we would prefer, since we are a duo, right? So we take a subject and then we go for that particular topic on research or workshop or tool making. So if you guys want to discuss things on a particular topic, we would like you to also take part and, you know, like maybe take it forward with A4 Achar or maybe independently. So that was a bit which I would like to make it clear. And I think that will be all. Please message us so that we could figure out like what other ways we could interact, maybe a forum, maybe a Slack channel, or maybe even a Discord channel, or whatever ways we could figure out. So that will be it from my side. Dhruv?
Am I audible?
Yeah.
Also, at this point, I would like to say that what we're trying to build is a space where we can have some indigenous toolkits to futures that we as a localized community aspire for. So we do pick on from various references here and there, but we try to localize the toolkit as much as possible for the activity which we're going to do today. And moving on. So So when we started off from to map the culture of work from home, so what we and what we usually do is, me and Praveen, is that we look at two kinds of research sources, and one of them is the cultural research source, and they can be GIFs, memes, and social media chats, etc., social media platforms, etc. And then we also try to look at mainstream journalism like newspapers and blogs and things which can be credited for. And so we'll start off with some triggers that we found, especially in the form of memes, and they're always very entertaining. So we'll start off from our own workstations right now. So the left one is my workstation, the right one is Praveen's, and very interestingly, both of them look very much the same, because fortunately or unfortunately, our workstations are centered around these devices, screens, to be very particular. And Praveen has two screens. So yeah, and moving on. So these are some memes that we got that. So these are not just basis, like sources of humor for us. Like we try to get memes from particular categories of a particular phenomenon. So for example, from work from home, there are various perspectives to look at it, that some jobs like railroad workers might just not find any relevance right now because of the pandemic situation. And how does work from home apply to certain things which are very site-specific jobs? And then this one talks about the blurring boundaries between the professional and the personal life, that you're confused between working from home and working for home. So this is also a usual since I'm a teacher, so I can relate with this meme here right now very much, that the cameras in our devices are have a very good knack for making us ugly, because they come from a very interesting technicality. And what would Pablo Escobar do when he doesn't have an access to a desk phone? So this kind of addresses that there are certain artifacts of the office or certain evidences in the office that we are really attached to. And this is a later realization that I have had, that earlier it was kind of an exciting thing to teach from home and everything and not leave home and work from your own comfort. But then you start to miss the environment you were in, and call it institutionalization or call it just being habitual to a space. You do miss office and some of its artifacts. So this became an interesting source. And then we had some news snippets. So these are like details. We'll just move on to the next one, where we try to get triggers from these snippets, that we look at people moving away from uncongenial cities because work is really becoming a very localized activity which you do from your own desk. So the absence of the necessity of an office really is making people question the cities that they're living in. And just on the merit of living, how well designed these cities are, or how conducive these cities are, is it time to really move away from these aggregated cities? And another thing is that companies are looking at complete work from home. So that's going to be a phenomenon that is going to be triggered whether the pandemic remains or not. So this will be like a residual effect that many companies are realizing that they're saving a lot of money. SBI, for example, State Bank of India, my father works in State Bank of India, and I could never imagine such an archaic institution planning a work from anywhere policy. So this is going to be a really interesting thing happening in this domain, particularly in the public sector jobs in India. And IBM has also reduced office spaces. And another thing that we understood that the current state of work from home and employees, the current jumble that we are in, the current ambiguity that we are in, employees aren't exactly happy. And like happiness is a construct, of course, but then many reasons like a blurring of professional and personal boundaries and the workload not being managed effectively and the absolute discomfort of the city that you're living in sometimes makes work from home a not so desirable activity also. And we have seen this rise of mental health issues during the pandemic and people living inside. Although there are like many reasons for that, but then of course confined to small spaces and not being able to experience a change of visual scenery is definitely one of them. And moving on, so what is the future of work from home? So this the next construct that we're gonna show you, it is a very preferable construct that we have built. Like we have picked in, for example, these keywords also, there's a lot of news that has been generated and trend forecasts that have been generated about work from home and work from anywhere and how and in what forms it will manifest itself. But we choose the triggers that we seem are preferable to our own idea. And another thing is that these, like the activities that we're going to do, they're not prediction of sorts, there are preferences. That we're going to choose a preferential scenario. So curation is really important of the triggers, that what triggers you choose for your world and what triggers you do not choose for this future that you're looking at. So for us, the triggers became a lot of things, and we're going to move to an activity where we're going to indulge you guys into putting your own triggers on the table. And it's a very simple activity. So we have a Miro board link. We'll just quickly copy it into the chat window in Zoom. So you guys can quickly go there. And Miro.
Wait for a minute, I think, so everybody could log in.
Yeah, and I hope people have an access to a laptop and they're preferably online through the laptop. So that will help, definitely. You have to sign up from a Google account. So I'll stop sharing the screen for once and I'll open the chat window. Raveen, are you putting it in the chat window?
Yeah, I have already placed. You just shift to the Miro board.
So I'll just shift to Miro. So Miro is this tool. I already see four people here and you guys can also see the arrows. So this is the interface that we're looking for. And wait for a minute or two so that people can sign up. And you guys can sign up from a Google account, and it's a fairly easy procedure. And then you should be able to land on this page titled WFH. And you should be able to see these arrows. So many of us are using this tool. I'll talk about the tool a little bit because it's a nice tool. And I came across this tool when I was teaching a class earlier this year, and it's become a very nice course management system. And then I realized that when I understood that this is a bigger tool. So it was called Real Time Board a while back. Now they have rebranded it as Miro.
Should I?
We wanted to be on this page titled Activity 1.
Okay, till we wait, I think I'll explain what we are trying to do here. You, as you can see, like there are a grid of 3x3, right? And on the left side, you will see there is an activity, and on the bottom axis, you could see it's called productivity. So what we want is just like, you know, we want to know what are the one of your personal anecdotes from your current work from home scenarios. Okay, we have just grouped it in the form that maybe few things you do with a group, you know, like with colleagues, or few things you do with your friends, or few things you used to do as an individual. So something like when you know, like when we were not working from home, going to smoke was something of a group activity, right? Where we would go with friends, and it was of a low productivity value. I mean, there is no work productivity to it. So if you say in similar way, if you want to put something like that, one of your anecdotes. Okay, just a second. I think I'll put the boards behind. So you guys can easily just, I think, trying to forward is better. Yeah. You anybody who wants to share their own anecdotes, what conversations they are having in their own life right now, work from home. So you guys can you know, take one of those sticky notes and just place it where you feel you know, it generally comes to. We'll do it like for 5-10 minutes. 5 minutes will be enough, I guess.
Yeah. I'll go through the...
Could you please repeat the activity?
Yeah. So what you have to do is, you know, you can pick one of the post-its from the left side, and you could put a few of the anecdotes which you have right now when you work from home. Like, I'm a freelancer, so it's... Like, you, if you could see where I've written that in the bottom productivity space, that I generally watch Netflix while listening to webinars. So it's a very individual thing, but this is what some of the ritual has been for me while working from home as a freelancer. So in a similar way, you know, like things which you are doing even right now, like if you come on a group call, for birthday celebration and some things like that, about interactions you have right now in your work from home settings, you just place it there. Was it clear, Ambika?
I'll just go through it again.
Yeah.
So we have like three columns of activities. One says that the activities of a low productivity spectrum, and a medium productivity spectrum, and a high productivity spectrum. So let's say Praveen says that he likes watching Netflix while listening to webinars. So he gets work done and he also enjoys himself. So I don't know how that is possible though, Praveen, like watching Netflix and watching a webinar and listening a webinar. It's just very ambiguous, but it is just what Praveen does. So this can come in a, so according to him, this is a medium productivity activity, which he enjoys individually. So the y-axis is the individual friends and family and group spectrum, and the x-axis is the intensity of the productivity. That is it a low productivity act, is it a high productivity act, or is it somewhere in between? So let's say I have put a thing that leg pulling and jokes during lunch. Somebody else has done this. So this, they're saying that this is usually a group activity, that during lunchtime you try to joke around with your colleagues and it happens in a group, and it's a low productivity activity. And who even decides productivity? That is a very gray area. You guys can have a very different set of rules for productivity. So I think it's you guys can get the hang of it now. We also try just filling along, and if you're out of post-its, you can just copy from another ones. Control C and Control V. And I'll just We'll just start again. Start up some warrants. We have these various colors here in this museum. So let's start reading out, listening to music and complete immediate tasks. So this becomes a high productivity task for someone, and it's an individual task. Using Figma or Discord for collaborating.
Can we put things in the middle, or they are supposed to be only in the rectangle?
No, you can put the things within the rectangle. Like in the middle, saying, "Okay, you want to create another spectrum between medium and high."
Yeah.
that is possible. Yeah. Why not?
Thanks.
Working at home with a baby. I don't see much pets happening. That is very interesting. Please put them. We have a lot of people here, but are there some people who are not able to join? That's really okay. We'll leave the link open for quite a
while. Your shared screen went off.
Yeah,
some people aren't feeling comfortable to sign up, bro.
Okay.
Maybe you can allow them on a slide on Google Sheet, and we can place that stuff onto one of us could just like simultaneously be pasting it on the Miro.
Yeah, we can do that.
Is Google Slides okay, Kiran? I think
we could also use the Hasik page, right? We can put it in the comments.
Yeah, we could put it in the comments, but so then
he already has it.
But then we'll not know where it fits in the spectrum, right?
Or we can just I'll try to copy the thing on the internet is breaking often, so not joining. Okay, Risha.
I could make a sheet if required. You can continue. I'll make a sheet in here. I'll just put a screenshot of whatever is the existing one.
Right. Yeah, that is also, you can just add it to the chat screen. You can just say that it's an individual high productivity task, and then you can just, yeah. We have a.
Then you need to continue sharing your screen.
Yeah, I'll just continue sharing the screen, and I'll keep adding. We'll keep adding from the chat box itself. Whoever is not able to join on Miro, you guys can just share the.
Through you share the screen, so we will add the from chats.
Raveen, could you just repeat how to take sticky notes? I'm getting some messages separately asking.
Okay, on this side of the screen, you might find, if you can look at the Zoom screen right now, so I'm pointing at a sticky note. So if you hover over it, it says sticky note, you can just quickly put it. And there are colors, and you can just put a sticky note. You can resize it. It's responsive. The font size will change according to the size of the sticky note. So you just need to start writing. Change the color. Or you can just copy an already existing sticky note, Control C, Control V, and you can just change it. That can also happen. So for example, I do some cleaning usually at midnight because it's a great time to just not have people walking in or you yourself walking too much. So that for me is a high productivity task, although I do not accomplish anything work related, but then that is productivity for me to get a clean workspace. So it is really subjective. You guys can take it your own way. You can already see that there's a lack of group activities right now, of course. And the individual section is getting a little crowded. And apparently most people are medium to high productive. Very nice. We are seeing fights happening about chores.
Okay, I think Netflix has become a very interesting topic for us.
I don't know if it'll create chaos, but perhaps maybe more people can talk on the mic and then it'll not be such a silent meeting. I don't know if that's okay with you guys.
No, it's totally fine. We prefer a very open forum for these meetings. It's just that it's online, so we haven't...
Open your mic if you want to speak or share or anything. Ask questions to each other. So the floor is open. People who are not able to join in on Miro, you guys can speak out your inputs.
Have you? Oh shit.
Why?
For me, I will join the team and work in the mornings. I can't work in the daytime at all because if there is any sound around me, I can't work. So I basically get all my work done at night, starting at midnight.
Nice.
Same for me almost.
So one thing that's that I find very similar are temporal boundaries, like timelines of the day are really changing for me, because I have a more sporadic sleep pattern now. I sleep like 4 hours and 3 hours, and because there's a lot going on simultaneously also. I have a main place of work and an agenda, and then I keep doing research and I keep doing my own things. And you're in the house, so you keep engaging in the house also. So I think sleep is one thing that we might find that everyone is affected somewhere or the other.
I think we have good enough responses from this exercise. We can move forward.
Yeah. Okay, guys, this is open for the Miro board. Of course, you have the link. There's no point closing it now. So you guys can keep adding while we are going on also. And we'll move to the next activity. So if you guys can just quickly look at the presentation right now that I'm sharing on the screen. And you guys can keep adding also in the mirror board. Just keep an eye here also. So moving on to like the preferable world that we were, we just went through an exercise where we tried to document our present day activities and kind of not only activities, some people have also shared like the bent of mind that they have, like the thought structure that they have right now in the form of an activity. So that is also very interesting that we are really seeing that where we are right now, this whole phenomenon of work from home happening to us. So this becomes like a very important collection of ideas, because collectively as a group of people, we are feeling a lot of things. That in itself opens up a lot of possibilities that can arise henceforth. So the kind of inferable scenarios that we are looking at is there are triggers that have been happening in the past few years, and one of the most interesting triggers that recently happened is that EIA is still it's not exactly passed right now, but then EIA is going to happen, and it's Environmental Impact Act, and how it's going to affect the larger chunks of forests, and how that is going to create a need for a more sporadic forest movement. So we look at a people's movement of sorts, where people start planting sporadic forests, not as an aggregated big chunk of greenery, but a small, more doable pieces of land which an individual can tend to. And we have seen these triggers happening in the past few years, where individuals have taken on extraordinary journeys to make larger chunks of land green, not only in India and in other parts of the world. And we also look at trends of urban vertical farms, where in cities like Pune, so I was recently looking at a forest school concept that is going to be developed in Pune. And it's kind of very much aligned to the ideas that we've already seen of the vertical forests. And we see some of, yeah, okay, Praveen. Okay. The host is asking me to start my video. Hi, guys. And hi. So, off-city habitats, we see a lot of off-city habitats happening where people move away from the very organically and how do you say it, from organized cities, which are not the best places for living right now. So we hope people realize that and they move to not exactly suburbs of sorts, but then a more intrusive kind of, how do you say, Praveen, can you add in here? Like, what exactly do we mean? You're on mute.
I was on mute, sorry. So it's more like people in our cities would prefer to move around, right? Like even if you are a corporate person, you are anyway going, moving around to visit places, right? So we thought that there will be a whole culture of corporate vagabonds. They will be always traveling around in different cities. For something called gypsy entrepreneurs, we thought, we figured that, okay, when people are more able to live at their own places, able to access technology very easily, so maybe more people will return to their smaller towns, and they will create companies there, and to use the networking effect, they will travel around like gypsies through different towns and cities to increase their networks, instead of just sitting in a center and having more employees to just go around there, because I think more people will be in entrepreneurs setting. Okay, and about the decentralized production centers, we thought since most of the production centers, like people have moved, even in this COVID situation, people migrated back, and the issue was that big factories were closing down, and I think the trend will pick up that big factories might not be a productive business. So people will move to second tier towns in India, and they will have more smaller factories, distributed factories, which is actually the general norm in our second tier towns. Even if you see an industrial town, it is more, except the bigger companies there, it is having a more collection of smaller factories run by individuals. So that is another preferred future preferred path we think we will be taking in India. And and just a thing I would like to make a point that this exercise of world building, we generally prefer to have a more opinions from people. So people maybe not don't want to see a decentralized production center, or maybe people don't want so techni oriented things. As Hugo is saying that about the existing corporate work culture, so maybe those type of scenarios people want to discuss upon. It's just that we wanted to do this online activity, so we wanted to keep it short. So we did this world building session. Dhruv, can you move forward? Okay, and about seasonal catalytic events, we thought that since people will be moving around, and there'll be much more regional festivals, so there'll be seasonal clusters. We used to have for every reaping of the crop in rural areas, right? And during rainy season, during autumn. So we thought that, okay, Yakiran, please, you want to say something?
Oh yeah, no, I just had, I found an interesting book a while ago.
Yeah.
It's called Pastoral Capitalism.
Uh-huh.
And it's actually a very funny book because, while this current discussion is about how you can finally leave the city and move back to your village or to your suburbs or whatnot, this book is documentation of how companies have done this for the entire of the past century. And it's essentially a book of pictures of workspaces set in rural landscapes. So I thought there's a funny contrast to throw in and say that people are thinking like this, but so are companies.
No, and that's what and it will be very grateful of you if you could share the book name with us. We would like to go through them. And as you said, right, like we would prefer such sort of a situation where it's not a centralized hub or what something some people call a Parisian desert. So Dhruv, moving on. Okay, yeah. And about the post-corona thing, we thought that we want to be a little hopeful of the healthcare system in India. So we thought that, okay, post-corona, there may be more outbreaks coming towards us. But due to this situation, we will be more prepared for healthcare outbreaks. So we will be more sensitized. We will know when we'll start using masks or how to be keep distance from people. So this through going through all these trends, we were projecting a world in 2030. Dhruv. So about that world, there is just one thing we figured that we want to bring to the conversation is that India in 2030 would be a world which is like work from anywhere, since there will be very less cohesion among the liabilities of working in a center or a city, and people are moving outside, production systems are outside, festivals are happening in different locations. So we wanted to imagine this world like, okay, in 2030, how it will be. You don't want to move to maybe Delhi or Mumbai, but maybe you want to just, you know, like 2-3 years, you want to work in some, we can move to those inspiration or visuals. So these are few of the inspirations or triggers we wanted to bring to the discussion. Or some things like you could easily see in the center, the XR headsets. So since with Geo Glasses came, we are thinking that, okay, it will be so cheap, just like our 4G now, or even smartphones. So everybody would be having such devices. And maybe we will be working in scenarios like Martian topology, right? Maybe you are talking to somebody in Mars and having meetings with them. Or maybe just a virtual vision of the Mars. And as you can see, there are vertical buildings. So, you know, you are living these tall structures, or it can be just farms. So you go to these vertical buildings, get your food, and you come back to your home for the next meeting, I'd say. And we will have some things like these huge, sculptural form of art and custom craft meetings or festivals in different regions. So each region can bring their own peculiarities and quirks to these festivals. And, you know, that could become more dynamic culture in India. And other than that, we might be even having such cars, which are like pods, where we are just traveling with everything. You know, like right now we have caravans, but maybe this is how we would like to travel. Maybe after college, students don't have to just go trotting on using a backpack. They take this car or rent this car, and then they can be moving ahead with this. So moving from those triggers, we want to open a discussion of if you are in that type of a future, what type of conversations are going to happen, right? What you think will occur during India in 2030? So I think we'll start with activity 2.
Ravi?
Yeah.
Am I audible?
Yeah, you're audible.
I'll just like to go. There was something wrong with my microphone for a while. I would just like to go through these. I'd like to explain each and every trigger that we have picked up. So this particular visual, I think you can see a black box right now, right?
Yeah.
This particular trigger is an actual place. I forgot the name of the town. So this is in India. It's in Himalayas. And this is a structure that is often leased by companies like kind of the companies that Kiran also pointed out, that they do some residential workshops where people come and they collaborate and they work. And it's a work from home sort of a centered place designed within a very natural surrounding. And this is a Sony headset, I think. Sony XR headset launched last year this was happening. So XR technology becomes a trigger. And so this Engage, a social meetup happened with a virtual backdrop of Mars. So they did a corporate event sort of a thing on a virtual location of Mars and enabled through various technologies like VR. And we had a similar thing very close to home also, where Ambika and Draft organized Algorave, or were a part of Algorave. I do not know the details. I'm so sorry.
No, organizer is different.
Oh, nice. So that in that particular event, the backdrop was Moon, if I'm correct. Yeah. So this kind of a world augmentation is already happening in the VR space, where people are saying, okay, we might as well just feel that we are in a different world altogether if we are working from anywhere, or we are like functioning from anywhere, or attending an event from anywhere. So that becomes a very interesting thing. And some universities are also applying this, although I'm not too sure of how good teaching would be in a VR environment. But then, yeah, experiments are happening where classes are happening in a VR environment. And it's very interesting. This is an Airstream 2018 trailer. And why I picked this is because we wanted to specify on some things like mobility, that a certain space that you can carry around, can that become a trend? And we would want that to happen, but then it is open to interpretation in what forms it happened. This is a very American idea of a caravan or a moving space. This is the school, proposed school in Pune that we were talking about earlier. So this is called the Forest School, and they have a cycling track. So this is designed by a studio called Nudes. It's a very interesting studio. You should look at their work and what they design. And it's a very interesting building trend that I thought that can be documented for this particular exercise. And this is the Burning Man Festival, famous and infamous for all its things. But then the beautiful thing I like about Burning Man is that they always construct something. So it's like a social a gathering of sorts in the middle of nowhere. And they make these awesome things and then they discard them completely. So that's also a cultural thing that Praveen was also talking about, that maybe social gatherings would dial down to certain events happening at certain point of time, which is also a very Indian thing. If you look at cultures of Pongal, Onam, which are directly related with the times of harvest. So what are the new forms of celebration now? What are the new causes of celebration now? So that can be a very interesting thing to ponder upon. And moving on, so you can come back to this slide again. We'll just share the link, because this has these triggers of sorts for the next exercise. And you can bring in your own triggers also, and these are very easily recallable triggers. And so the next exercise, we again go to Miro board. And what we do is, let's just get there and explain there itself. If you guys can come back to Miro. So, there's this panel called Activity 2. This is a kind of a prompt statement that we thought that this could be a statement that we can fill as a group. And like each one can fill their own statements. And so what we're trying to emulate here is a conversation that you're doing with a person in the year 2030 and while working from somewhere. So what the idea of this exercise is very important, I think, to explain first, is that whenever we look of producing things from timelines that are not the present, so these artifacts, so usually moving away from tangible things like products, etc., becomes helpful, because this becomes a more inclusive way of everyone can design a conversation, we think. And so a conversation from that future becomes a interesting artifact to have today. So if you can just quickly come here. So what we are essentially talking about is we want you to have a, I'll just unlock this, but please do not change the statement right now. We'll just quickly unlock the things, and you guys can unlock yourself also. There is a lock button. So let's say it's a conversation about something with someone. Someone can be an individual person or it can be a group of people. While working from somewhere. So I think this becomes a little more explanatory. So these three blanks you have to kind of imagine and fill. So these are the cards right here. If we move a little bit. So conversations about something, conversations about last night's party with a colleague while working from.
Guys, sorry, just to interrupt. Guys, the board for activity two is on the right. So when you join the board, if you move your Miro board by clicking your space or pan it towards the right, you could see the activity. I'll create a link from there. Okay, Dhruv, please.
Yeah, the activity, so this is the activity board one, this is activity board two. So these are kind of the cards that we have. These are two formats of cards. Very easy. So this is a group chat. We have taken the format of a chat because it becomes more relatable. And Praveen, I think we should lock the background. I've locked it. Yeah. So that it doesn't move. You guys copy from these cards. And we would not want to give an example conversations because we think it might just set the tone a little bit. And what you can look at is these some triggers that we have put in the bottom. These belong to all the three categories, somewhere, someone, and some something. So you guys can start just constructing conversations. We'll also join in this activity. And you can just see how we are going about it, and you can just try your hands at it. And people who are not,
you guys can take one of the sheets. I'm just copying different formats. So if you want to have a group format, I'm placing it in the last row.
In the Zoom chat as well, I'm placing the statement. So it's very easy. You guys can, if you're not able to access Miro for some reason, you can. Just start filling it in the chat itself. So I've just put in the statement, and you can, I'll just put in an example as well in the chat, and it can become a exemplar for both of the things. And
I will share in the chat.
All right, you can do that. For example, where they can you guys can also take the mic and speak up if you have anything that you want to say. You can copy the cards and
Hi, Anisha here.
Yeah.
Sorry, I've never used Miro before, so can you just take me through it? Like, so I just have to copy paste these panels and then add my conversations?
Here is a small interesting thing. Some of you might be having some irritating trouble with the mouse also. So just go to this panel which says this, the settings panel right here, and there's a navigation mode. So you can switch to a mouse or a trackpad depending upon the thing you are on. So that helps you navigate more naturally, instinctively. So,
sorry, can you show me again? I missed it.
You go to the settings thing.
Okay.
This place, and then there's a option called navigation mode. There you can choose between a trackpad or a mouse.
Yeah, that's fine.
So let's say I'm working with a mouse right now. So I'm on this arrow and I want to copy this card. So I can just press shift, hold shift.
Mm-hmm.
Then I can select this like this. And I can just control C and control V and I'll have a copy of it.
Sure. Okay.
And you can just edit it, like double clicking on the text, and it becomes normal text field. you can start writing.
Okay.
And within these shapes also, if you double click on the shapes, it becomes a text field. So you can just start writing anything.
Okay. Okay. Thank you.
These are conversations that you're having in 2030. So that has to be kept in mind. So try to extrapolate and try to leap a little bit into thing. And it's really a good, it can help you if you start thinking about these things first, all the three things, that what is that something that you're talking about? So what will be things that you would be talking about in so let's say I would be talking about so I'm looking at let's say crafts are a thing which are close to me, so let's say I'm talking about
so these words down are like triggers, right? Like
Because you can pick from these, or you can just add your own also. It's really not, you can interpret 2030 in a very different way, but a sense of the world that we have preferred would be nice, so that
okay,
it remains like a cohesive exercise.
Okay. Yes.
Yeah, and if you guys want to increase the text size, when you click on the box, to double click on the box to write, you'll see there is something on the top. There is a control box. You can increase the font size there if it's getting hard to read.
Yeah.
If anybody has, you know, like done with their sheet and would like to discuss, then we could like discuss that here while I think while through Phil's sheet.
You guys can add more boxes, chat boxes. The conversation, and you can extend the background white page. I've logged the yellow background thing, so it's open now. I'll lock it again so that it doesn't move around much. And then we'll lose sense of the home screen. We'll have another 3 to 5 minutes to this. Then we'll leave it for the group. Just a suggestion that your conversation should be a little descriptive about all the three things that we're talking about. That what are the people that you're engaging in conversation? What is it that you're talking about? So just a very generic acquaintance kind of conversation would not kind of do the trick of, you know, really getting your heads out. So yeah, and you guys can like really just take very imaginative leaps. So it's not a predictive exercise that what you might become in 2030 and what you might be doing. It's also a sort of an aspirational exercise where you can like put in your own assertions that I want this to happen, or I want a certain kind of environment, or I want a certain kind of people to work with, or whether or not it's a obvious growth from your present thing. You can really choose an alternative reality of sorts also. You can choose a very different profession or a workplace which you're not associating with right now. You can step into other shoes also. That is also welcome. Font size of 36 to 40 might be readable for everyone on this particular size. So, bigger than that can also happen if you have fewer words. Otherwise, we can also moderate the things later. Praveen, I think we can. Try to wrap it up here a little bit.
Yeah. Okay. If anybody wants to share their story, like what their vision is, that would be great. Or else we could, I could start with mine, which is generally very weird.
Somebody wants to go first? Or Praveen, you would like to start it off?
No, I can wait. I mean, anybody wants to go first with their vision, even if what you are thinking is good enough for us.
Then you can start off.
Okay. No. So, I have felt something like, okay, that the conversation is about laundry with a colleague while working from a treetop restaurant. I think I'm here.
I would like to add just one more thing, that if you look at this place here on Miro, if you can follow my screen,
okay, once. Black box is there. Yeah.
Is this plus 11 kind of thing that you and there are 11 more parties. You click on it, and if I find Praveen here, so I can just click on Praveen's name and my screen would automatically follow what Praveen is seeing right now. So this is kind of like Figma. People have that experience before on Figma, so you can find it here as well. So yeah, Praveen.
Okay, so it's something like what they are discussing about laundry service. So one person is talking about that the boss is picking up on why the dress is like so dirty, and they are having problem with the laundry because they didn't use a detergent there. And then the other friend is in Shillong somewhere, and she's talking about this, missed every time they are on a video call with the for work. So it goes to something in the sense that the first person tells about ki, you know, maybe I have to shift to the local organic disposable leaf dresses. So this is a imagination. I'm taking a leaf here that, okay, maybe there is something called a leaf dress. So the other person asks this, like, what is the leaf dress? And I imagine that it's something which you make by sticking leaves in a geometric pattern, which makes it strong and easy to wear. And then the other person gets curious and they also want to order something for them in their own location. So in my future, there are conversation happening about fashion at some weird location at a treetop restaurant where you are using the leaves of the tree itself for dresses. Okay. Anybody would like to go next?
I can give a shot at it.
No, it's kind of pretty perfect. Sorry, like I was halfway on my mobile and now I'm on my computer. So bear with me if I miss some bits of it before going through it. So yeah, I picked the topic of activism with children while working from a coffee house. So this is, I'm imagining down the years, it's like representatives are kind of worshipped like idols, and people have their idols in their shrines at home. And I'm asking, like, what do you think is the best way to convince the representative? And one of the child represents, given that he is the most popular among his followers and most people have his idol in their shrine. So the reply comes in is like, true, knowing that he has a following, it definitely makes it hard to change his mind because now you know that you have a major support. So just going with like more like a tribal mindset, as one of the kids is like, I would say we should start with a sacrifice that might convince him like that we are on their side to get them attention. So the other person says, another child says that we are giving into their methods by doing this. So they have like their own moralities kind of coming into place. And then lastly, the other person who had suggested that idea says like, when you have a representative like that, that's the only way to get their attention. So yeah. Pretty wild kind of thing. So this is kind of, I went into the projection of something like Cloud Atlas. They had this thing about one of their activists becoming a religious god kind of a thing down the decades, just because they had fought for their independence. And it on brought like a tribal kind of a society where the extremely rich had abandoned the planet, whereas those who were left behind were living in a tribal kind of a setting. So, yeah.
Thanks so much for this.
Very interesting.
Yeah. Can we have like a one or more, two more people discussing their things since we are like way past our time?
Yeah, we can. I can, if other people would like to go, then yeah, it would be better. Because we have been, Ayush wants to go. Ayush, you can.
Yeah, hi guys. Am I audible?
Yes.
Yes, you are.
Yeah. Okay, so, okay, this idea comes from this movie, Her, where this character plays this game in his apartment. So, my idea is based on that. So, I've been, you know, following this new technology PS5 is bringing. So, this is a conversation happening on new mediums of entertainment with a friend or colleague who's also a fellow gamer. And I'm sitting in my apartment. So, I'm just telling him about this new VR headset that PS5 is bringing and how it is so much immersive. So, what I picked in this narration is a game from 2010, which was Alan Wake. So what I remember from this game that the levels and the stages were so dreamlike sequence and everything. And I only wished if I was that character, so how would I experience? So I was sharing this conversation with my friend and that the guys, the developers, they have picked on this idea only and they are trying to deliver that experience. Ki jab us samay when we were playing through character, we were making him go through all those stages and everything through, you know, places deep in the woods or, you know, some kind of fantastical place. Now, how is it like when you are so much immersed in that kind of place and you are getting to have that experience? So, yeah, that's my thing.
That's very cool. Ayush, I like you are having to become a natural, artificial persona, right? I saw Anisha raise hand.
I can go. Anisha, are you here on the screen? Or yeah, not?
Yeah, yeah, I'm there.
I just follow your, yeah. Yeah.
Who is going? Who is talking? Sorry.
You can talk, Anisha.
Okay, let me find my... Yeah. So, I mean, somehow I didn't thought about technology as such, but I was thinking around the terms of, like, you know, building houses and studios around your work and nature. So, like, you are building, if there is a tree, then you are not sort of cutting out the tree, but, you know, you are making the tree as a part of the house or a studio. And I don't know if I'm in the right track here, but this is what I thought of 2030. and there are a lot of biotechs that's coming, so if you can use that to build a space around nature. I have to think about what are the ideas that can be used for.
This is more like with nature of sorts, that you respect the nature structures also, and you build kind of in adherence to it.
That's very interesting.
Okay. So this is like a conversation with family while working on a home-based studio. Okay. So the person is like arguing the point of building with nature.
Okay, I think we'll take one more. Pranjal raises hand, and after that, I think we guys will wrap up. The board will be open, so you guys can add your conversations or change the conversations. Yes, Pranjal, please.
Hi, Dhruv and Praveen. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Yes, Pranjal. Hi. Hello.
So I modeled it around. So I'm assuming that technology is. Digitization is on a level in India that most of the local bodies are connected. And so I'm talking to a virtual assistant, Siri. So I'm talking about a new recruit living in a mountain cottage. So maybe I'm running a cafe. So the conversation is like, I'm asking that Siri, have you completed the background check? So since all the local bodies are connected, digitized, so Siri is able to send his or her information and get the background check. Then I'm asking if there are any comments from municipality or the police, and so they are able to confirm. So my idea is that if we are able to take the infrastructure or the technology to the tier two or the rural areas, we will be able to accomplish, at least from IT or some point of view, that we only have the pressure in the mega cities because we don't have the infrastructure in the rural areas or the outskirts. So once that is there, then virtual assistant and everything is there as well.
Right. This kind of also in agreement with a point that was raised earlier, that you in like particular US has like corporates of US in the US have capitalized on a lot of low-cost rural area settings, and they have like brought power. Uski wajah se, like because of this happening, there's a lot of power grid development being happening in the rural sector as well. Although like it's debatable ki wo, how much of a development it is, but then yes, rural is becoming empowered because of companies moving in. That is for sure.
Okay, Dhruv, I think we should wrap up now.
Yeah. What are you saying, Praveen?
Yeah, I think we should wrap up because we are like way over the time.
I'll just go once with, if anyone else doesn't want to go, then I'll just go through my, or you can just read it here. I cannot find it. Okay, here it is. So I kind of chose a very obvious thing from the triggers, which says that the last office of a company is being shut down, and this is a conversation that my future self is happening is having with my coworkers while I am on the back of my friend's scooter, because I can really work from my cell phone as well. So I particularly try to imagine a device that how would back of my friend's Activa would become a functionalish space, if not exactly functional. So I just thought of a isolation helmet that you can just wear if you're anywhere for Zoom meetings, and it just isolates your own scenario. This I picked it up from Get Smart movie. They had an isolation cone. So someone is saying, can you dial down your environment noise? So someone else is saying, yeah, but should I wear my helmet? So the person is saying no. So I'm saying that the agenda is that we need to collect our stuff from our cubicles because the office is closing, and what to do. So the person says, let's go day after. And I say that, okay, I'll set up an appointment with the security, which I kind of want to hint at that you cannot just no longer walk into office spaces again. You need to like really have a reason to go to those establishments while they are on the verge of closing. So yeah. Cool. So we can like wrap it up unless we have something happening in the chat. Okay. Cool. So we can wrap it up now. And this board is open for any kind of addition. If you want to use this thing somewhere, you can just use it. Try your own little activities. Or if you have suggestions on this, they're most welcome. This was the first time that we did an activity where we are talking about conversations and cultures on this in this particular format. So this is a new format for us. So you can give any of feedbacks, what worked for you, what didn't work for you. And we can take that into account the next time we come up with a workshop. And thank you guys. I would like to thank HasGeek and Ambika and Aditi Najabhar because they fostered this conversation. And they're really amazing people. You should just look at all of their work. Yeah. And you can look at our Instagram at A4Achar. We have a new handle right now. We've just created an identity and we're planning to put on more content there as we go along. We are working on our website also. So we just wanted to be like a good one. So we are not like giving any sneak peeks or like just we're taking our time with it. So for now, Instagram would be a good place to look at the work that we're doing and sharing. So yeah, if you have some feedbacks, you can mail to us at a4.hr@gmail.com. And Praveen would like to say something.
Yeah, like guys, please message us or mail us what we want to, you know, like think about the session and what you maybe have in mind to initiate the conversation. And maybe if you are wondering what to do, what we will do with these conversations, we haven't thought particularly of an artifact. It's just that there was this discussion with me and Prabhu. I was suggesting that maybe there will be an Alexa app for this because I can make it maybe. So you could have these conversations there just for having fun. And if you guys would like to access this video or even these contents later on, you guys can go to hasgeek.com to our page and find these videos and the chat conversations there. That will be all. Thank you for joining us.
All right, guys, the links are public. You can keep accessing them.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, guys. This was really fun.
Yeah.